Hey everybody, Dark Prince Plays here, letting the curtains rise on another episode of my Let's Play of Mario plus Rabbids Kingdom Battle. In the last episode, we made it through more of the Sherbet Desert. Kinda. We just did this one really long level, and that was pretty much it. So if you haven't seen the previous episodes, make sure before watching this one so you're caught up with everything that's happened up to this point. This time we're gonna be continuing through the Sherbet Desert, on our way to find Toadette. And what was the... Oh yeah! They were having the standoff. I was gonna say, what were those two doing? Yeah, we'll be able to find Toadette and probably do the mid boss, which, wait, was this canon here? Probably. A bonsai bill. Might as well do this, because we should be able to buy a new weapon from the coins we got in the last one. Last episode, I mean. Okay, that one was a little too easy. Watch, it's gonna be a bad item because of how easy that was. Blastberry Swirl. Sweet victory is yours when you unwrap the long-lasting, flavorful mix of damage and secondary effects. Here's the thing, I don't think I'm gonna use Rabbid Luigi in this next fight, but I wanna see what this is. Because Bugglers. Oh yeah, that's another new enemy type that we haven't seen yet. And oh god, they're really powerful. So, and kinda scary. So vamp damage. Has a higher vamp chance than Shining Dawn. And a better chance against Bugglers. Pretty powerful. Is this the first weapon that we've seen that does medium cover damage? Wait, no. Oh, no cover damage. Why haven't I looked at that? I think that's actually our first weapon with medium cover damage. That's... I'll see. But for now, we can actually head on into the mid-boss. Yeah. Well, 2-5 is... 2-5, the gatekeepers. Or was it crashers? I didn't really read. Of course, he just flew around it. Lizzie and Sandy, hot and cold creeps. So yeah, now there's two mid-bosses. Not like we've dealt with that before. Okay. But in all seriousness, this one could be quite tough. I kind of forgot what to do here. I think the optimal strat is to kill them first? Or no, I think it's target one at a time and then go for the other one. Probably Blizzy because it has... I don't know if it's a he or she... It has less HP, so we got it's a villain sight one shot. It has precision that can inflict freeze, which I think that one prevents you from using your special abilities. And then Sandy has a grenade duck, which can inflict burn. Shield. Oh, you have a perfect shield, so we're probably gonna wanna go for Blizzy. Ziggy, I'm pretty sure there's a supporter somewhere. No supporters? Really? I thought there was... I remember there being a way for them to heal themselves. Let's just go with this, because I feel like I'm going to want to use Luigi. same music as for Rabbid Plan, I guess. I don't want to separate them, so... I kind of wanted to keep everyone all together. gonna target Blizzy first. Wow. What a start, actually. Targets have range, which sucks. Target Blizzy. Is it worth it going for Hero Say? Let's go for Steely Stare instead. It's a bit of a tongue twister, but not really. Okay. Wow, okay. There was no need to hit that guy back there, but oh well.
Oh no.
Oh, come on, Luigi. Oh, they're targeting the sentry. Oh god, that hit everyone. Oh my god. Oh, Luigi's dead. That's a problem. Like a really big problem. It's only the first turn and one of our guys are dead. Empower. I thought we'd be able to kill Blizzy already. Okay, looks like we're gonna have to deal with only two allies. Okay. Because again, the main thing you have to do is kill the mid-boss, which... dealing with one of them should make things a bit easier. I think. Golden shot. We don't need to heal yet. Okay. Damn, like, you killed Luigi immediately, though. I don't think I'm gonna get over that. Probably gonna want to heal Mario soon. Does heal reach? Yes. I wonder. Nah. Are you in range? Yes, you are, actually. If we could go the pipe, that'd be great. Can we shoot? Thing that sucks is that we're not able to, go up. So that's fine. You're lucky I have better things to do. Let's go to the Hero Site. Percent chance bounce. Rats. Actually, I think I want to take care of you just in case. Okay. I thought that was going to set off Hero Sight. Thank God it didn't. And let's move Rabbit Peach. Please don't see him. No! Okay, well, at least we dealt with the Ziggy, so they're not going to be any trouble anymore. We might have to solo this with Rabbit Peach if this keeps up. No. I don't... Hold on. You can't dash. you can only move. But Mario's like really low on HP right now. But he can throw behind cover. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna move here. This would be great if it could bounce. Oh, it worked! Okay. Of course. Okay, let's go closer then. Rats, okay. Just stand right out in the open then. Alright. Sentry. I might solely attack the sentry, actually. Nope. What happened? Is Mario dead? He's not dead, but... Wait. Wait. You just screwed yourself! You fool! You ignorant fool! Mwah! You just screwed yourself over. I don't know how he won. But hey, Rabbid Mario. Whoosh. He's a hockey puck.
What the? Ah, I see our frozen friend has finally decided to join us. Pale imitation of the real thing, of course, but still. Any ally in the fight against Bowser Jr. is a welcome sight indeed. I suggest we withdraw to Princess Peach's castle to get our new companion up to speed.
How charming. Good. Yeah, the only thing is that Luigi died, which... is not good for us. But hey, the gate crashers. Reward of 900 coins is not bad at all. Rabbid Mario joins the team. Melee brawler, lure enemies and hit them hard. Boombastic runner, dash up to 3 enemies in a row and blow them up. Battle HQ Rebellatory updated. 12 new weapons available. Get powerful new weapons for your heroes. Please tell me the coins are still there. Yes. There should be... Okay. Were there any coins anywhere else? No. But hey, we still got a lot of episode left to go, so... let's actually listen to Beepo and head back to Peach's castle now that we got new things. Do you really want to warp to Peach's castle? I mean, we don't have to, but like... If you wanna, I guess we could. Okay. So back here, and we got new things, because, like these kite things are from, Sherbert Desert. Okay. Alright, Battle HQ. So now... I'm gonna go over Rabbid Mario. So, Rabbid Mario, a big league brawler with exceptional luck and a dependable defense, solid moves, and massive case of imposter syndrome. So, he also, first things first, Rabbid Mario also introduces us to a new weapon, so the boom shot. I don't think we haven't seen it yet, right? A new enemy type's gonna be getting that soon. But basically it like kind of like spread, it's like it does spread damage in front of him and can hit multiple enemies at once, but I'm pretty sure it can also friendly fire, so you're gonna want to watch out for that. And his dash also does splash damage, so like you could pretty much combo enemies with it, which is really nice, like especially if you can get them all in a bunch. Basically, to sum up Rabbid Mario, he's a one-man wrecking crew, basically. You can do a ton of damage and also take hits pretty well. Yeah, I guess as of right now, just slightly more HP than Rabbid Luigi. So pretty good, actually. Oh yeah, and I should also mention new ally or any power orbs we collect, like that's just how many you have for like each ally, so whenever we get new ones, we're just able to spend like there's no tomorrow, so new skill unlocked, boom dash, an explosive area attack Rabbid Mario performs with a dash. Let's give him his melee, close range weapon that can hit multiple targets at once, just like Mario's. Magnet Dance. Enemies within range are drawn to Rabbid Mario, which could be really good in dealing multiple hits. Wait, he can do up to three. That's what I was thinking of. Let's get him in one of those. And he heals out his bodyguard. Say boom dash. Put down two turds. Only protects him from dashes. Oh, that costs a lot. Let's go for. Team jump. As for Luigi, we should be able to, yes. Okay. Now pretty much everyone's on the same, everyone's pretty much on the same page. Weapon selection. Okay, Chawjaw. Bat 1,000 with this little beauty. Ceramic Panic. When this is all over, let's hope this vase can go back to holding something nice like roses or one of those fresh fruit bouquets. And now we're starting to get into medium cover damage weapons, too. So, pretty much an upgraded version of Bonsai build, but does not have an increased chance on supporters. Mighty Bits of Mario. Pain Sprayer. Portable, easy to clean. It delivers twice the pain in half the time. No air compressor needed. And then Birch and Urchin. Much like the spiny gobbler animal, which... after which it's named, adversaries will find this beauty tough to handle, or accidentally step on. If you're out playing the Wild Rover, passing through fields all of Ireland over. Alexa, stop! What was that about? Okay, whatever. Increased push chance. Push damage. See, I kind of have a lot to think about with these new weapons. Just regular Luigi. Oh yeah, the Brontosaurus Rex. It looks hilarious and also in constant pain. Possible influences here include the dinosaurs, the Loch Ness Monster, or the creature from the Block Lagoon. I'm probably gonna wait until we get this one. The Stinger. Don't be deceived. It may look cute, but this fuzzy little venom is venom boasts a bodacious bite. Does not do honey, but actually inflicts push somehow. And then the Bulletinator. Watch foes sweat bullets on the battlefield when you lock and load this mean-looking munition. Yeah. And with Rabbid Mario. Oh yeah, so we should probably go over this. So Red Lightning, be the storm of the horizon. On the horizon, victory is yours in a flash when you discharge a powerful blast from this boom shot. He also gets Koinobori, I think. It's big, mighty teeth when it comes to taking down opponents. This baby's got teeth. Wrath of the Dragon. This fire-spewing beast of a boom shot is no myth. Enemies everywhere, beware. Be dragons. So yeah, Rabbid Mario's two status ailments are Vamp and Stone, which you already know how I feel about stones, so let's buy him an upgraded boom shot for starters. And we did scan the Mario amiibo. Oh wait. Big Blue Bopper. Enemies got you down? Bash the blues away with this blue gown type weapon that'll leave them black and blue all over. Deadbolt. No one gets past this powerful melee weapon once What springs to action? Victory is a lock. Globber Chomper. You'd think after making this the rabbits at Peach's castle would avoid Chain Chomps at all costs. Turns out rabbits love the little rascals. And then Bone Shaker. Shake a leg, get ready for some bone rattling fun with this skeletal swatter. Alright, so since we did get this from the Mario Amiibo and it's free, might as well equip. And we are able to buy another weapon, however, 30% burn, 30% burn, let's play Mario Ceramic Panic. But I think that's good for now. Oh wait, I also want to, I think my go-to team is going to be Mario, Rabbid Peach, and Rabbid Mario. I think? Because, like, Mario, you're kind of stuck with, and I guess he's a good all-around, Rabbid Peach is a good healer and also has pretty good defense. And then Rabbid Mario is a one-man wrecking crew and can do a lot of damage in battle. I think we're good. Still don't want to go back to the Ancient Gardens and do stuff there yet, because I still don't think we're quite strong enough, but I mean, we are slowly but surely powering up, so that's at least worth something. Alright, so that'll about do it for this episode. Next time on Mario plus Rabbids Kingdom Battle, we'll continue through Schubert Desert. Actually, for real next time, hopefully do more than one battle, and probably show off what Rabbid Mario can do. So, I'll see you guys in the next one, and goodbye!